Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Today's project, friends, is going to start from my Tinkercad profile. Notice on my webpage, you can simply go down here and click on the HLModTech button. It shows you all my designs, but friends, we want a circuit and we want a new circuit. So if you hit recent, you will see the LED remote 2023 tutorial. There will be a link to this also in the description of this video. Once you get there, don't forget, make sure you always click on it and give it a reaction. And then finally, click copy and tinker. Friends, in this project, I'm going to teach you how to set up the remote with the IR receiver. Now, I have already added one LED and I've added one resistor. I do want you to start by clicking on that resistor, and I want you to change it to ohms, and I want you to make it 100 ohms. You can click on your LED and you can pick any color. I'm going to make mine yellow. I'm going to start by connecting wires, and I want this wire to come up. I'm going to click so it makes a bend, and I want it to come over, and then I'm going to bring it to number 5. Once it's in place, I can straighten it up so it looks even more cool. I can also click on it, and I can change the color. Since I used a yellow LED, I'm going to make the wire yellow as well. Now, whenever you connect LEDs, you need to find the cathode, and we need to connect it to the negative rail. I'm going to make that black, just because that's traditionally how you show the negative. And then I'm going to go over here to the ground. I'm going to connect a black wire again and a black wire again. Notice I'm going to click, bend to get it so that that whole rail is all doing the negatives. While I'm here, I'm also going to do the power. I'm going to click, bend, click, and connect. But because that's the power, I'm going to change it to the color red. Once you've got them in place, you can also drag and adjust, or if you wanted extra bends, you can double click and add extra bends in the middle. Now, friends, we need to find the remote parts. So if we type remote, you can see we have an IR sensor. I'm going to set that right here, and then we need the IR remote, and I'm going to zoom out, and I'm going to put it down below. With those in place, let's do some minor adjustments. I'm going to move that up one row, and then we're going to connect this pin where it says power to the power. If you look at this pin, it says ground, so of course it's going to go to the ground. Now, once again, same as before, because it's the ground wire, we're going to make it black. And then the next part is the out. Now, this one, I'm going to click right here in the white area so it'll bend. I'm going to bring it out, and friends, it connects to a special pin number 3, and I'm going to pick a funky color for it. Let's go with the crazy pink, and I'm going to show you why that pin goes there. So in the background, you have not seen this, but there is some magic code. So this is the code right here. It uses the IR remote, HPP, that's included, and then here is the receiver pin number 3. So that's why we just moved this over to number 3. If we move down, it's got a special IR receive code where it starts. It tells it to decode, and then it enables it. Right here, this is starts receiver, and then PID mode 5 is output. Check it out. Right over here, we connected to number 5. Now, it says we're going to use 6, 7, and 8, but I'm going to teach you how to do that on your own. When we get down here, you can see there is a loop where the receiver decodes a value. That value is then changed to raw data and named value. This is the old way the code used to work. I changed that as it adjusted, and then this is how the button is labeled. I'll show you how to get these cool codes in a minute, and then we will code more buttons using this template. So friends, with that out of the way, watch this. When we hit start, it tells us that it's loading, and friends, when we hit number 1, bingo, our light comes on. So if you look over here, when we pressed this button that had this magic code, we told it, hey, this means number 1. And if we hit serial monitor, you can see a 1 came out. Then we also did a digital write of number 5 to be high. That turned the light on. And then we broke the code so that it would reset and keep looking. This is the magic part, friends. Make sure your serial monitor's loaded. And when you click 2, bingo, That's our code. So right now we're going to hit stop simulation, go down to our code, and we're going to copy this template. Right click, copy. I'm going to go up above and I'm going to right click paste. I'll add an extra enter, and now these had slashes which made them a comment. If we backspace through all those comments, that is now a workable piece of code, and all we need to do is adjust it to fit the right numbers. So remember, this was the number 2 code, so we're going to copy that, and we're going to come up here and we're going to paste the correct code in. We can delete the word template, and this time it's going to say number 2, and it is going to be button 2, and we want to digital write number 5 low. So now it will turn on and it will turn off. If I hit start simulation, it double checks to make sure we did all that correctly. Notice you always have to have the semicolons. Notice if you ever want stuff to not count, you need to put slashes after it. Friends, when we hit 1, it turns on. When we hit 2, it shuts off. We have now got 2 working buttons on our remote. If you want to get button 3 set up, which is what we'll do together, there you can click on 3. This is our magic code. Now we've got to stop the simulation. Remember, if you ever can't type, it's because you didn't stop the simulation. And let me show you how to turn a second light on. So we're going to start with our parts. Click on your LED. Do Control C and Control V to set in a second one. Make sure you move over a chunk. Pick a different color. I'm going to go with green. Click on your resistor. Do Control C and do Control V as well. When you set this one down, we're going to do something cool with it. We are going to rotate it. This is our rotate tool. This lets us stand this up so we have more room. Once again, it is going to be connected to the anode. And then from the anode, we're going to connect to pin 6. I'm going to pick a different color of wire. This time I'm going to go green because I chose a green. And I'm going to go up. I'm going to bend. Let's come down and put it in that hole right there. Remember, if you want to add another bend afterwards, you can just double click the wire and pull it down so it looks the way you want. I'm going to switch to the black color because, of course, we've got to connect this side to the negative rail. And friends, it's time to do the code. So let's go back to our code button. I'm going to put a slash slash here, and this will be forever in your real one from now on. And let's do Control C. Press Enter a few times and do Control V. Of course, we got to backspace over those. If you make a mistake, you can always do Control Z. Now my code is available to change. I'm going to go down here and copy this. Right click, copy. I'm going to go back up here and do Control V. Notice it did an enter, so I'm going to do backspace to connect that. I'm going to delete all this because I don't need it. I could have left it though, because slash slash makes it a comment. This time when we press it, we want it to have a label of 3. Over here, we're going to label it button 3. And this time we want number 6. And I'll point to that in a second. So right here, remember we plugged into number 6. And we want it to be high. Do note, you do need to spell it correctly. I am going to do all capital letters as well. Accidentally, when I clicked on this, I switched this to a black wire. Let's change it back to the green. Once again, I do like that strategy. And let's hit start and test it. Once again, if we click 1, the yellow one turns on. 2, it shuts off. If we click 3, the debugger kicks in because I had accidentally double-clicked on this spot. If I shut that off, we can resume execution, test it, and bingo, it works like a champ. Friends, let's figure out number 4 and turn it to an off button. Once again, when we click it, that gives us our code that we're going to use, and then we can simply scroll down here. And this time I'm going to use my code up above as my template. Once again, copy. I'm going to press enter and I'm going to do control V. We need to go down here, friends, and we need to right click copy. We need to go up here and we need to swap that out. Now this is where we need to be careful because we don't want two of these. And I'm going to do right click paste. My code has been switched. Now we need to make it 4. I'm going to name it button 4. And then down here we want 6 to be capital L-O-W for low. Let's hit start simulation. And then test it. 1, 2, 3. Notice that break is still on. I'm going to shut that off by clicking that 38. Now when I resume it so the debugger is off, 3 works and 4 shuts it off. I could also click 1 and 3 to have both on. So friends, you have now learned how to program on and off for all the buttons. Your challenge is to repeat this for pins 7 and 8. So when you're finished, you should have 4 LEDs. They can all have their own colors and they all can have their own on and off switch. If you're getting brave, you can also add more pins by increasing the amount of code out here and then of course wiring them the same way. Of course, when your project is complete, don't forget return to the Tinkercad dashboard. And if you want to share your project with the world, click up here on the properties, change the name to something you want. I'm going to put my initials. If you want to mention that it was from a HLModTech tutorial, you can also add a link up there if you want to help people find it. Friends, as you tag items, if you tag anything you ever make with HLMT23, I search that tag every day to see the cool items, and of course I give them reactions. Finally, make sure you set it to public, and then I am choosing attribution non-commercial, and finally hit save changes. Then friends, the cool thing is to click on the gallery. Of course, it'll start with all the staff picks, but instead you can shut that off and see the latest creations. You do need to make sure you switch to circuits. And check it out, we have to scroll down, but right there is the project that I just made. Once again, friends, if you ever see something you think is cool, make sure you give it a reaction. Friends, as I wrap up, I just want to remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. I've got a tab dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of awesome categories. And then below that, you can find my day one favorites and also useful starters. And then finally, the Tinkercad essentials. Friends, also at the bottom corner, I want to share the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Lastly, friends, don't forget the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, don't forget you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.